like me cause that like she can't count on him. She tried to be nosy and hit up my ex. She like, girl, you can count on him.
Hey, hey, we need more, tell him we need more. Putting numbers on the board, let them keep a score. Hey, 16 cars in my front yard. Hey, 30 on my wrist, bullet point to God.
Big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team counted, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, blue hunts. Whole team count, that's a big number.
Yeah, I just ran a check up on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Seattle Seahawks. So here is the punter, Matt Bosher, to get us started. And we are underway from Atlanta. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line.
Incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. Yeah. I just had to let you know. Yeah. Give me that work and I can sell it. I put it on the line like I ain't selfish, nah. The story flip if I let you tell it. Put my heart and soul in so you feel it. I ain't never faking, I'm the realest. Tupac in the prison, man, claiming his innocence. Currently, I'm the greatest rapper in a sense. But any currency, I'm still guaranteed my wins. This is coming from within, I stuff for real, I don't pretend. When the OG spilling knowledge, bet it's best.
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and we are in the Pacific Northwest at CenturyLink Field in Seattle, Washington. This crowd, as we've come to expect in recent years, as loud as any in the NFL, and they get even louder when their Seahawks are introduced. We're ready for football as the Seahawks get set to do battle with the Atlanta Falcons. This is fielded at the goal line. He's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Trinity!
Check 45 to Mike. Here it comes, here it comes!
They'll throw on first down with Wilson, eluding the pressure right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. A bad start there. A big loss on their first play from scrimmage. It's second down. To try again after the sack. Wilson, that's called setting the tone. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Adrian Claiborne, his second sack of the night. Well, someone came to play today.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. We heard about it all week, didn't we? Especially when we visited practice. He thought he had a good matchup in front of him, and he's taking full advantage right now.
Deion Jones. That's now back-to-back sacks, and it brings up fourth down.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board.
Now here's Michael Dixon. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. Returnable here from the 38. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Falcons are set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. First time with Devontae Freeman. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
On second down now, it's Freeman, and the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
This is Freeman on first and 10. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
On second down, Freeman. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 14 yards there and a Falcon first down. On the heels of that good carry by Devontae Freeman, here's first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Ito Smith, his first carry. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. No score after one on EA Sports. Take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. A 6-yard touchdown run as his guys are on the board first here tonight. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Seahawks take over first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
And on the first drive, three and out. I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the
beginning. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. They've had touchdowns on both of their drives thus far, but now they face a third and long. Decent gain on the scramble to six, but now it's fourth. They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. It's fourth down. 45. They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. Steps away to his left. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, and now it's first and 10.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Now it's Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson, and they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack. Back at the 47-yard line, Devondre Campbell flies in to blow that play up. Third and long, it's Wilson. Forced out to his left. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. And they will advance this across midfield, but still well shy of a first as he's tackled at the 47. It's fourth down. Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Escaping the pressure right. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Pete Carroll rolled the dice, but it didn't work out. And the Falcons defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They have to be thrilled with that first drive that got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here on the road.
And you know, they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
Tackle coming from the safety, Trey Flowers. The last run got a couple. Here, second and eight. Now Ryan going to give it to Freeman. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. A gain there of 21 yards.
I have a pretty good friend, Charles Davis, who tells me that when he sees plays like that, strong runs to the right, reminds him of the 1960s Green Bay Packers.
Boy, those were the days back when the fullback actually carried the ball as well as blocked. Then you had a halfback. He had pulling guards, guys who could get out and run. And you can hear the great coach saying it back then. So we get a seal here and a seal here, and we run this play right in the alley.
They'll run on first down. Freeman. The tackle there by Quandre Diggs.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Slam, slam. Tight dog, tight dog. 59, ready.
And now a 10th carry for Freeman. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. On first down, it's Freeman, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts, as it will come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
Here we go.
On second down, it's Freeman. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as he'll try to get 3 before half. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And his kick is right there. It's good. So a late 3 there, and that'll help as they head into the break.
Talk about situational football and something they've worked out since the OTAs and minicamps the previous summer. They take care of the ball, get 3 points, knowing they're going to get the ball to start the second half. That's the old 2-for-1 special to finish things off.
Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And the Seahawks looks like they've recovered. They have. So they hit the ball before it went 10 yards. I know that's tough, but you got to stay disciplined.
It is difficult because you're so eager to go get the football. It's that type of a play, but you're exactly right. Have to have the discipline to let it go 10 first.
And he put enough leg into it, but it's well off to the right and no good. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the 3rd quarter.